and welcome to another weekend vlog. It's Saturday the 21st of January. We're nearly there. January's nearly done. Less than a week to payday. If you're like me, I get paid next Friday. So hang on in there. We're getting there. So yeah, Saturday morning. It's about, let's look at my watch, 9:45. I've just finished getting ready. Ta-da. I think we're going to head into Birmingham today. I think we might try and go to Nostalgia and Comics, which is brilliant. So it's like loads and loads of geeky stuff, and then upstairs it's like a big comic section. Maybe a little wander around Chinatown, into the market, because Oliver wants crab claws. Well, he did last weekend. I don't know if he's going to still want them this weekend. And we didn't make it there last weekend. So I hope you've all had a good week since I last saw you. I should probably just give you an update of what's been happening. Last weekend, if you watched last weekend's vlog, we went to the Licky Hills to watch sunrise, and then we really didn't do a great deal after that. And that was because Mr. S really wasn't feeling very well at all. He said to me that he had what he could only describe as a toothache in his chest, which was quite worrying. So all of last weekend he really did feel quite rotten, so we didn't end up really doing very much. So it reached a point this week where I was like, right, that's it, you've got to go back to the doctors. Now, I took him back to the doctors last week and they sent him for a chest x-ray at the hospital, which we did, and the chest x-ray, the quick look they took at it while we were there, they said, yeah, it looks really clear, it looks fine, but we'll send the results to your doctor. So he went back to the doctors this week. And the good news is his lungs are clear, his chest looks clear. The bad news was they saw he had a fractured rib. So this would explain the pain that he's been in, the poor chap. Because he said to the doctor, he said, well, excuse me, that's my feet moving around. He said, it hurts every time I reach with my left arm. And he said, well, it will do, that's your rib. We think he probably fractured it when he was coughing last year, because he said he felt something crunch. And it was probably when the lung went and I think the rib must have gone or something. Either that or, excuse me, when they did the chest tube. I don't know if that caused it or aggravated it or quite what. We don't really know. So, yes, and the doctor has said to him that he probably won't feel completely 100% better until the end of February. Because he's been really worried because the hospital didn't really give him any indication of how long this would take to heal. Then he's had like a weird sensation in his arm and he said it felt like he had an ice pack on his hand, which the doctor has assured him and is like where the nerves are all repairing themselves from where the tube went in. But that seems to have settled down and he's a lot better. He's not in so much pain and he's a bit more chipper. But the doctor also said to him that he thinks he's probably lacking vitamin D, which at this time of year is no surprise really. It's quite foggy out this morning and it's really cold, really frosty. So what he has done, because Mr. S does suffer with SAD in the winter months, he's been and bought a light box from Maplin yesterday, and he said it's already really helping how he feels. I think it was about £49.99, so not really, really expensive, but also not desperately cheap, but I think it's got like 10,000 lux. It's so bright, really, really bright, and it's really good. So if you struggle with this time of year, if you suffer from SAD, it's definitely worth looking into light boxes. This is like a little mini one. It's really, really good. I'm trying to see it. I don't know where it is actually for me to show you at the moment. I'll see if I can find it later and I'll show you what it looks like. So I guess that's been a week really. I've been really quite worried about him. I have, but fingers crossed. He seems a lot better since he's been to the doctor. I think it's just put his mind at rest that what he's feeling is quite normal, and most of what he's feeling is from the fractured rib. Obviously, there's nothing they can do to treat a fractured rib. You just have to take it easy and it will heal in its own time, you know. And the doctor said there's nothing you can do. There's nothing you can do to prevent it either because the coughing has caused it. What I might do this year is look into flu jabs later in the year for the winter. I'm not saying it'll miraculously stop all of this, but he's had 2 winters now where he's had problems with his ribs from coughing because he's been so poorly. And I really don't want another winter with him being so ill again. It's been horrendous. So we'll see. Anyway, so that's been my week. How's been yours? So yes, into town, hopefully. I'm just waiting for Oliver to get himself sorted out, as always. Always what I say, isn't it? And we'll catch you all in a bit. Right, so we're now in town. We've just parked at the Arcadian. Oh, it's a bit stressful. Oh, I'm zoomed in, I am sorry.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's like a rhino, isn't it? On top of that building up
there. Yeah.
And he's all glittery. I do like him. So there he is. Look, we're a bit closer now to the rhino. Now, this is the car park you use if you're coming to the Hippodrome or the Arcadian or Chinatown. So, look at that pink wall. We're out and in.
Oh,
lost. No, we're not lost. I know where we are.
I don't.
Don't you? And there's the rhino.
I know we're in Chinatown.
We're at sort of part of Chinatown. If we come up, there's the Hippodrome ahead of us, just in the distance. And you can see all the lanterns because we're in part of Chinatown. God, it's really cold today. So we're going to head over to Nostalgia and Comics,
yeah,
which is like on just on the other side of Chinatown. It is. This is Chinese supermarket. People out and about. I love this part of town. I think it's probably my favourite. It's the Arcadian. It's always super packed on a Saturday night. It is. Oh, my hand's cold. Ooh. Oh, that's the back-to-backs there. You can go around those. They're owned by the National Trust. I've always wondered where they were and what they looked like. So that's them. In fact, if we cross over, we can go and have a look.
I had a suit paid by that.
Did you? By George Sanders? Oh. So this is the back to backs. Yeah, I'm going to the comic shop in a minute. Ah, they reopen on the 31st of January. They're undergoing maintenance. Oh yeah, look at those old-fashioned irons. Oh, if you fancy something different, the Birmingham back-to-backs. Oh gosh, got the old. Is anybody else old enough like me to remember the yellow paper, the yellow stuff like this, the yellow stuff they used to put in windows to stop it from fading, wasn't it, in the sunlight? You've got to be a certain age, I think. Oh, sweets. I remember buying sweets like this out of these tubs.
Yes.
I do. Sugar-free sherbet lemons. Antifrat cakes. I like those pink and blue, those ones. I think those are my favourite.
I like those.
Do you? Sherbet lemons. Oh, chocolate limes, I love chocolate limes.
Cola Bills.
Cola Pips.
Pips.
Oh, I used to love Cola Pips. When I was a kid, I've seen Cola Pips for years.
Oh, look at the old...
Not today, because it's not open, because they'll be open at the end of Jan. Yeah. We'll have to come back.
They're not open at the moment because they undergo maintenance at this time of year. Yes. Because they have to keep it, because it's old, they have to keep it preserved. So people can keep enjoying it. So this is the Hippodrome.
I went there.
You went there, didn't you? What did you go and see?
I can never say the name.
Dick Whittington. Yeah. And who was in it?
Captain Jack from Doctor Who.
Yes, Captain Jack. There's the thing. So that's... Must come back a bit. There's more of the Arcadian over there. If you're coming to Birmingham and you want a night out, it's a good place to go. Also, you can set, look, I like that the H look is all Chinese lanterns, because of course it is, next weekend is Chinese New Year.
Would that be to promote Cinderella for next year, that carriage?
Could well be, because it is Cinderella this year, isn't it? At the end of the year for their Christmas production. They're already advertising this year's Christmas panto.
It's next year, it's this year.
Yeah. Mr. Egg. A Birmingham institution. I've never been to.
Pigeon.
I've never been to a pigeon. Well, was it like a Pokemon pigeon?
No.
Pidgeot.
What's it? I have a mega Pidgeot.
Mr. Egg. Sure, many a hungover person has been in there after a night out.
Is it actually the path or is it a road?
No, go on the path. So, the home of Snobs. Again, another institution of Birmingham, Snobs Nightclub. I used to go to Snobs when I was a teenager. And it's moved now to that black building on the corner that you can just see there. The wall of faces that it's known for moved with it. But I don't know that it's quite the same anymore. I don't know if it still has the sticky floors like it used to.
It's sticky floors.
Sticky floors where everyone has spilt their drinks. Oh, Ming Moon. I want to go to Ming Moon. It's a big Chinese buffet. I suppose it's really good.
Sushi.
Sushi. I really want to go to Ming Moon.
I've tried sushi, but I've tried soy sauce, but I've never tried wasabi.
You've never tried wasabi? No, I've never tried wasabi. Or sushi, for that matter. I'm not keen.
I tried sushi, but I think wasabi can be really spicy.
You liked sushi, didn't you?
Yeah.
See, there's Snobs.
My favourite one is the one that's in there. The one that's in Jazz Jacket Potato Skin.
Ah.
Yeah.
Snobs. That's a big advertising board there.
What is it called?
Why is it called Snobs? I don't know. It just is. That hotel, oh that's it, there's Nostalgia and Comics. Above it is the Holiday Inn. Years ago, I went to a Red Dwarf convention there and saw all the stars of Red Dwarf, which was amazing. I'll go across. Which is brilliant, which is up there. The Holiday Inn, in the Holiday Inn. God, I'd be glad to get inside, my hand's frozen.
How do you do a convention in an inn?
In a holiday, in a hotel.
Yeah.
They have a big room. Oh. A big room that they hire out. Charger and Comics. Look in the window. See all the stuff they sell. It is. So we'll go in and have a look. We'll be right back. So we've left Nostalgia and Comics up there, Mirena, hello. And we just buy, I'm going to have to come back. This is Fair Deal Music. Now, I go past this music shop every night on my way home from work. I've never got this close to it. Look at these guitars.
The two ones that have been swindled from the
studio. Amazing. It's an amazing array of guitars. But look, I don't really know why. There's a suit of armour in the window. Random. But I suppose if you want a guitar, this is where you need to come. They're not crash, they're not cheap. 1016. They do look amazing though. I always wish I'd learned to read. Let's play the guitar. What's that? Gothic suit of armour on loan from Historics. www.historics.co.uk. Oh, okay, so they've got it on loan. Look at all this stuff. Amazing. And you look inside. How about that one? Yes, I always wish I learnt the clarinet. That was as far as I got, and I wasn't very good at it. I'm not very musical. I'd like to be, but I'm not, sadly. If we walk down a little further, they've got another window with other things in it. Which you can have. Look at all this. Oh, look at that. Gramophone. Oh, look at those.
Dinky one.
Well, that's not that much bigger than, not that much smaller, sorry, than the one you had from school.
Bagpipes.
Have they got oh yeah, bagpipes.
Wow.
Clarinets. That's what I learnt to play. I've seen a gramophone. That's what I learned. Oh, there's a flute. I would have fancied playing the flute.
Yeah, I could play the flute.
But I learnt a clarinet, and I'm trying to look at those makes of clarinet to see if any of them are the ones that I can't remember what mine was now. They were such a nightmare. It all comes apart, and you have all the wax that you have to use on the stuff to like get it all together. Then the reeds that you have to put on, you have to buy all the reeds and put them back in. And then they split and go horrible. And then a little silver cap that goes on the top when you're not using it. And the nice little boxes that you keep them in. I can still remember the smell of the reeds and how they used to taste. Gosh, it takes me back. It's a long time ago. I think my parents bought my clarinet from a shop in Shirley, near Solihull. They did. It had all blue velvet in the case. Beautiful. It's a long time ago. Trumpet, anyone? Anybody fancy a trumpet? Wow. Saxophone? I would have liked to have played the saxophone. So yes, this is the place to come. Look at that record. Do you know, my first record player that I had off my mum and dad that was theirs didn't look dissimilar to that. Look at that one. Oh my gosh. I had a drum machine. I had a really rubbish Yamaha. That's terrible. Is that the bows for the... Yes, yeah. Your bows for your violin. Oh, love all this kind of stuff. You know, I miss having a record player. I do. I sold all my vinyl, which I bitterly regret now. So there you go. You're coming to Birmingham, you want to buy a guitar? You should come here. Amazing shop. Oh, look at all these. That's really ace. I want one of those. That's so cool. Oh, look. Michael Jackson. please. Fleetwood Mac.
Aye, mate.
So we're now in St. Martin's tea rooms. It's Mr. S. Oliver's opposite me. Can you see Oliver? Are you there somewhere, Oliver? Hello? And we're all, we're all having hot chocolate. Don't normally drink hot chocolate. It's a rare treat. Look at this. Oliver's had, what have you had? Marshmallow and cream on yours. Well, he's devoured all the cream already. Now he's on the marshmallows. Hot chocolate and lemon drizzle cake, which is really nice. It's so cold outside, so after we left the music shop, I didn't film anymore because my hand literally was going to drop off. It's so quiet in here. I feel like whisper almost. This is the tea room that's part of St. Martin's Church. Down beneath the ball ring, or just on your way to the market. Not many people get down here, do they, probably?
It's really good. I mean, this is Saturday morning.
And it's really
hardly anybody there. Yeah. So if you ever want to come for a cup of tea or a coffee, it's coming here.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
Because it's so quiet and chilled and relaxed, isn't it?
Yeah, and you don't. You want to get away from the crowds.
Oh, yeah, it's far from the maddening crowds in here, isn't it?
It's a good place to come.
But it's lovely. It's really nice food, really nice drinks. We sometimes go up for a little wander in a church because it's just so busy and mad outside. And literally, you come in here and it's just so quiet and warm and peaceful. It's really nice. Anyway, I'm going to enjoy my hot chocolate and I'll catch up with you.
Oh, we
could
get some crab claws.
Get some crab claws?
Yeah?
Crab claws? We're down in the market at the moment, the outdoor market. I've got some money. Come down to get some bread. So noisy down here. Like I say, we're down in the outdoor market. See how loud it is, everybody's shouting. All the fruit and veg. Just bought some, well, we just bought some rolls, haven't we?
Enable.
Like the cottage ones. Like little cottage roll. Is it a pound a bowl?
Kabul darbar, kabul darbar.
That's really good. We might get some oranges.
Brothers, get.
There we go, you can buy fabrics. All sorts. Everything. Yeah, we're going to go into St. Martin. Oh, we're going to go in there now. It's 10 to 12. 10 to 12 now. Six for a pound. been and bought a dressed crab for Oliver from the market. Now, I was going to film in the market, but what I'm going to do is a separate vlog just of all the markets, the indoor, outdoor rag market, because there's so much to see. I think it deserves a vlog of its own. But this is walking back into the Arcadian Cafe Chino. I want to go in there. I do. It looks so cool. I love it down here. This is where you come for Chinese New Year. They have all the celebrations here. They have the dragons, and it's really good. Really, really good. That'll be next weekend. So yeah, I think I need to do a market vlog. If you think you'd like to see that, let me know. There's all sorts, there's like all the fish stands. We were just looking and we just saw octopus and oysters and crabs and lobsters. Every type of meat. It's brilliant. So this is the Arcadian. I'm just heading back into the car park. So I'll catch you when we get home.
So hello, it's now Sunday afternoon. So I need to start with an apology really, because I probably quite abruptly finished filming yesterday when we were out in town. My plan was, we got back to the car and I was going to film when I got in and just talk about stuff, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, long story short, I got in, I had the most horrendous migraine, I felt rotten. So I ended up going to bed at about 1:30 and I slept for like 4 hours. I didn't get up till again till 5:30, I felt really bad. And then when I did get up, I still had a bit of a dodgy headache, which stayed with me all through last evening. So I just wasn't in a fit state to even sit in front and look at the camera, because I looked awful. I won't lie, I did look terrible when I got back up. And I really didn't feel very good. So it kind of blew my Saturday afternoon out the water there, because I ended up spending it all afternoon in bed feeling really poorly. And I really didn't feel that great last night. And I woke up this morning and it was still there. It was like right over one eye. And I'm pleased to say, touch wood, think it's now gone. I do feel a lot better, I feel a lot brighter. I'm sat here with my glass of Diet Pepsi. I think that might have been a problem, not Pepsi, but dehydration. I didn't drink as much as I probably should have yesterday, so I think I'm dehydrated. But what I wanted to show you, which I didn't get a chance to yesterday, was what I bought from Nostalgia and Comics. When we first got in there, my eyes were drawn to the lanyards. Now, I did actually, in all seriousness, I did need a lanyard. I need one for work, because I have to carry various things around with me. So I got a BB-8 lanyard. It's got BB-8 on that side of the lanyard, and then it's got the Star Wars pop thing on the other side. And then you get this little bit here. I might take that off, because I think that might get in my way. But what I really loved, he's looking at a little BB-8. How cute is that? I love BB-8. So I'm going to use this for work, to put my pass on to get in and out of work. And then I could use the current lanyard that I currently wear to put some keys on that I have to carry about with me. So that's what I bought. I just bought that, and Oliver had a Five Nights at Freddy poster, because he loves Five Nights at Freddy's. I'm really sorry, I've got a dry throat. I've just been out quickly to the shops, and the cold air has made me cough. So yes, I got that. It's only £3.99, which I didn't think was bad actually. Because if you go on eBay, or sometimes you go online and look for these, they're quite often a lot more money than that. The last time I looked at a Doctor Who one, I wanted the Doctor Who one with the little bow tie. It was about £8 or £9, and I thought, oh, I don't really want to pay that for a lanyard. So I should be wearing that to work tomorrow. And then the other thing I was going to show you, I didn't buy this yesterday, but I did do a little cheeky Primark spend earlier in the week, because on Tuesday, Oliver had to go to the Hippodrome. I say had to go, he was going with clubs to watch Dick Whittington with John Barrowman in it. Oh, I'm so jealous, he got to see Captain Jack. And I had time to kill before I met him and Mr. S, so I slipped into Primark. I haven't been to Primark for ages. and the one I go to in town, everything had moved, so I was like completely confused as to where anything was. So the one thing I did buy was a pair of trainers, because I had a lovely pair of slip-on trainers that I bought from Lolly. Lolly likes fashion, go and check her out. And they were so ace, but they just fell apart. I literally wore them to the point where they fell apart. And I needed some new ones. So these caught my eye. Look at those, complete with the little zips. They're so cool. They were £8. And I thought, well, for £8, you can't complain, can you? It's about the cheapest I've managed to find, because I think in New Look they're usually about 10 or 11, and in Deichmann they're about £15 for the sort of same thing. So £8, and I thought, well, for the summer they will be perfect. So I got those, and the other things I bought were I bought a little necklace for £2. That one there, if you can see that, there it is, £2. I just thought that was quite cute, really, for £2. Because I mean, and it's rose gold coloured. Obviously, it's not rose gold, obviously. Because rose gold, sorry, this Pepsi's repeating on me now, is everywhere. It's like the fashionable colour at the moment. We've gone from everybody liking silver and sort of silver and platinum colours to everybody wanting rose gold. So I picked up one of those for £2. And the only other thing I grabbed, because I needed some, I do like Primark's makeup. Up until now, I was using the basic £2.50 foundation, and I decided to spend a whole extra 50p, a whole 50p on this one instead. They're two in one. This is their two-in-one foundation and concealer, dewy finish, for £3, and this is in ivory. Oh, it's got like a weird diagram there saying that you, what's that mean then? What, that you open it and you get like a, oh, you get a mirror. Oh, okay. Well, I didn't see any of that when I picked it up. That's weird, isn't it? Shall we have a look? Shall I see if I can get the wrapper off and we'll investigate what's in there. So you get, okay, let's open up this lid. Oh, so you get a little mirror like that. And then I think in there is the concealer, is in there. And then I guess in that, where's the foundation? Oh, the foundation's in like, then you screw, and then the foundation's in there. Oh, clever. Oh, it's got vitamin E in it, if that's something you're bothered about. It contains vitamin E. So I'll let you know how I get on with that. Because like I said, the £2.51 that I was using, I quite liked. And it probably didn't last really that long. But it was quite pale. And I've got quite a pale skin tone. It's hard for me to find a foundation that isn't too orangey and yellow. It makes me look a weird colour. I haven't got any makeup on. I do apologise if I scare you all. I just can't be bothered, it's Sunday. This is how I look without any makeup on. So yeah, I'll let you know how I get on with that. That should be quite good for a whole extra 50p. So yeah, so it's Sunday. I'm going to finish off the vlog now. I'm going to go down. I really haven't done all. I've done absolutely nothing today. I've literally sat in my jammies playing Tropico 5. I think I'm going to be saying that on pretty much every weekend vlog I do. I'm going to be like, yeah, I'll just play Tropico 5 in my jammies, you know. But the time is currently, I think it's coming up to 4 o'clock-ish. I don't know, because I haven't got my watch on. And it's still light behind me. If you follow my Instagram, I don't know if I mentioned this yesterday, but I did post a picture at about 4:25 going, oh my gosh, it's still light, it's still light, it's amazing. It's definitely making a difference. I can definitely feel the days getting that little bit longer. I'm still going to work in the dark. I still get home in the dark, but it's a bit lighter. So it is making me feel better, actually. I felt so much better than I have. But flipping heck, it was cold yesterday. Oh my gosh. I really wish I'd put a hat on. When we went out yesterday into Birmingham, I was absolutely frozen to the bone. I don't know if that's what gave me a migraine, the cold weather, because I had a bit of earache as well. I don't know, it's either, or I'm sickening for something, which I really hope I'm not. Anyway, I'm going to sign off now and go and finish playing Tropico 5 with my glass of Pepsi Max. Other soft drinks are available. Anyway, thank you all for watching. As always, you can find me on Twitter at GamerGirl0621, on Instagram at Natty Nikki. I have a Facebook page, Natty Nikki, if you want to go and give that a little cheeky like, that'd be much appreciated. My blog is www.nattynikki.com. I think that's it, really. So thank you for watching. I hope you have a good week until we meet again. Let's hope this week treats you well. We're nearly there. By the time I see you again, I will have had my payday. Yes. And January will nearly be done. We're nearly there, kids. We're nearly there. It's nearly February. We're getting there. Anyway, take care and have a good week till I see you again. Bye.